Please be seated. Graduates, families, and friends, I am pleased to introduce Dr. Stephen Leath, President of Iowa State University.
I'm delighted to welcome you to the 2012 Fall Semester Commencement Ceremony for Iowa State University. Commencement is one of the most important and significant ceremonies that a university holds. For our graduates, it represents the culmination of years of hard work and the beginning of an all-new and exciting journey. For the family and friends of our graduates, it's a time to share in the success that their graduate has achieved and to be recognized as well for the wonderful support they have provided throughout the years. And for us here at Iowa State, it represents the successful completion of our most important responsibility to society, to educate the next generations of scholars and leaders in our country. We take great pride in that accomplishment and in the achievements of our newest graduates achieving this very significant educational milestone. I'd like to begin today by introducing the members of the platform party. First, Iowa's Lieutenant Governor Kim Reynolds, who will deliver the commencement address. Dr. James Barnard, Global Practice and Technology Leader for Black & Veatch and today's honorary degree recipient. Dr. Jonathan Wickert, Senior Vice President and Provost of the University. Dr. Thomas Hill, Senior Vice President for Student Affairs. Dr. Kath Ann Kress, Vice President for Extension and Outreach. Dr. Pamela Anthony, our Dean of Students. Dr. Olivia Madison, Dean of the Library. Dr. Simon Estes, F. Wendell Miller, Distinguished Artist in Residence and Commencement Vocalist. Ms. Michelle Stotts, Vice President of the Iowa State University Alumni Association. Dr. David Holger, Associate Provost for Academic Programs and Dean of the Graduate College. Dr. Wendy Winterstein, Endowed Dean of the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Dr. Pamela White, Dean of the College of Human Sciences. Mr. Luis Rico Gutierrez, Dean of the College of Design. Dr. Beata Schmidtman, Dean of the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Dr. Michael Crum, Interim Dean and Raisbeck Dean of the College of Business. Dr. Mafit Akinch, James L. and Catherine S. Melser Professor and Interim Dean of the College of Engineering. Dr. Shijing Zhang, Associate Dean of Research and Graduate Studies of the College of Veterinary Medicine. Dr. Suzanne Hendrick, University Professor and President of the Faculty Senate. Ms. Laura Doring, University Registrar. And the many distinguished faculty representing Iowa State's academic departments, please join me in recognizing them.
Dr. Wickert. Dr. Jonathan Wickert, Senior Vice President and Provost of the University, will now begin the honorary degree presentation.
At today's ceremony, Iowa State University is privileged to bestow its 136th honorary degree. Dr. Suzanne Hendrick, President of the Faculty Senate, will now introduce the distinguished recipient of the honorary degree to President Leath.
Will Dr. James Barnard please stand? President Leath, on behalf of the faculty of Iowa State University, the Faculty Senate has recommended and the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, has approved awarding the honorary degree Doctor of Science to Dr. James Barnard. Dr. Barnard serves as the Global Practice and Technology Leader for Black & Veatch, an international engineering, consulting, and construction company in energy, water, telecommunications, and management consulting projects with more than 100 offices worldwide. He is one of the world's leading environmental engineers, and he is recognized internationally for developing biological nitrogen and phosphorus removal processes from used water, which has revolutionized water treatment. He first introduced the processes in treatment plants in the United States and Canada in the 1970s, and he has since been involved in the design and construction of more than 100 such plants worldwide. He remains involved in design and studies for the improvement of these systems. A native of Cape Town, South Africa, Dr. Barnard earned bachelor's degrees from the University of Stellenbosch and University of Pretoria, and master's degree in environmental engineering from the University of Texas at Austin, and a PhD in water resources from Vanderbilt University. Prior to joining Black & Veatch, Dr. Barnard was director and president of Meyring & Barnard Consultants in Pretoria, and worked at the National Institute for Water Research in Pretoria. He is the co-author of two books and author of many publications in his field. He is a fellow of the Water Environment Federation and was the first recipient of the Koch Imhoff Award from the International Water Association. Among his many awards are the South African Academy of Science and Arts Gold Medal, the Thomas R. Camp Medal, Lee Kuan Yew Water Prize, and Clark Award.
Thank you. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, as President of Iowa State University, gives me great pleasure to bestow upon you, Dr. James Barnard, the honorary degree, Doctor of Science, with all attendant rights, privileges, and obligations.
President Leath, Lieutenant Governor Reynolds, honorable guests, distinguished faculty, today's graduates, ladies and gentlemen, it's indeed a great honor for me to receive this honorary doctorate from such a renowned university. I see this as a final vindication of standing up for common sense. When I started my research, the world population was half of it is today, and there were already signs of eutrophication and overfertilization of lakes and reservoirs from excessive discharge of nitrogen and phosphorus compounds, mostly from used water treatment plants. The environmental engineering community in the 70s, with few exceptions, became convinced, or maybe I should rather say obsessed, with the concept that we should abandon biological treatment and pursue more manageable chemical treatment for nitrogen and phosphorus compounds. Nevertheless, Mother Nature doesn't need chemicals to remove these substances, but uses biology, and I became convinced that we should be following this more sustainable approach. With little support and on a shoestring budget, I developed biological processes that could simultaneously remove these nitrogen and phosphorus compounds. The results were so unbelievable at the time that I was accused of being a snake oil salesman. However, my institute leadership and many prominent professionals were adamant that chemical treatment was the future of environmental protection, and proposing biological alternatives was like running into a brick wall. For years, I was ostracized and ridiculed. Perseverance finally paid off, and now billions of dollars are being invested in this technology. However, I've always shared the knowledge with the world and with other than professional fees, never profited personally from this research. Getting an award like this one today from a premier research university more than makes up for that. My message to today's graduates is, when you come up with a good idea with great promise, but it goes against conventional wisdom, stick to your guns. Never give up on a good idea, even if the whole world is against you. Thank you.
President Leath will now introduce today's commencement speaker.
We are honored today to have as our commencement speaker the Lieutenant Governor of the State of Iowa, the Honorable Kim Reynolds. Lieutenant Governor Reynolds grew up in St. Charles, Iowa, located in Madison County, and began her work in the public sector as a motor vehicle clerk in the Clark County Treasurer's Office, but she was destined for more. She was elected Clark County Treasurer in 1994 and was reelected three times. In 2004, she received the Outstanding County Treasurer in the United States Award. In 2008, she ran successfully for the Iowa Senate. And then, when former Iowa Governor Terry Branstad decided to run for another term as governor, he selected her for Lieutenant Governor position on his ticket. And on November 2, 2010, the Branstad-Reynolds ticket was elected. Lieutenant Governor Reynolds is a strong advocate for strengthening STEM education, science, technology, engineering, and math. She is the co-chair of the Governor's STEM Advisory Council, and she is the only elected official named to the 100 women leaders in STEM. Her other responsibilities as Lieutenant Governor include serving as co-chair of the Iowa Partnership for Economic Progress Board, the Military Children Education Coalition, and as coordinator of Des Moines Symphony's Drive Against Hunger, and she serves as governor's representative on the Iowa State Fair Board. She has participated in, or she has led trade missions to Germany, China, South Korea, and Thailand. And in February 2012, she and Governor Branstad hosted China Vice President Xi Jinping, soon to become the next leader of the world's largest country on his visit to Iowa. She is active in the National Lieutenant Governors Association and a great Iowan. She and her husband, Kevin, have three daughters and four grandchildren. Please join me in welcoming the Lieutenant Governor of Iowa, the Honorable Kim Reynolds.
Well, thank you for that very kind introduction, and good afternoon. President Stephen Leath, university officials, distinguished alumni, fellow speakers, family, friends, and most important, the class of 2012. It is an honor for me to be here today, and I am humbled to take part in this important tradition at one of the country's leading universities, Iowa State University. My husband Kevin, our three daughters, and in fact our two son-in-laws, are graduates of this fine university. So Iowa State truly is a special place for our family. Without question, the Cyclone Nation is alive and well at the Reynolds household. But if there are some Iowa Hawkeyes and Panthers in the audience today, please know you're not forgotten. Our state thrives on having a spirited yet friendly competition among the three universities. We are so fortunate to have such strong and passionate supporters throughout Iowa. Today, I would like to talk about the power of the unknown and you. We are living in a global economy that is filled with plenty of unknowns. And sometimes it's those unknowns that can stop people in their tracks or keep them from reaching their full potential. So together, we're going to take a journey that covers taking advantage of the unexpected opportunities, moving beyond the unknown with courage, and never backing down from your true self. So, how do you take advantage of the unexpected opportunities? As you begin this new chapter in your life, it's easy to be apprehensive about the unknown, but also excited about the opportunities. Just look around Hilton Coliseum. Aren't you a bit curious about which graduate today will be the next tech titan among us? Or who will be the inventor that develops a new composite that reduces the expense of running the next generation of transportation equipment? Or who has the ability to cut through the clatter in teaching young minds? Or who among us will be the next Norman Borlaug discovering a new seed variety that will help feed a growing world population? It's really inspiring to look out among you and see the next generation of talent ready to walk out these doors and conquer the challenges that are seen and unseen, challenges that will shape the world in which we live. Personally, what I find so exciting about participating in a global economy is the ability to shape its foundations, create new businesses, or develop innovations that can improve the world. That's why it's so important to keep your options open and be aware of those unexpected opportunities. Since an early age, I've always been curious about how people take advantage of the unexpected opportunities that life presents us. Is it because some are luckier than others? Or maybe some people are magnets for success? Or perhaps they just happen to be in the right place at the right time with the right people? It really is a fascinating concept if you think about it. How do people take advantage of the unexpected opportunities in life? Maybe entrepreneur and Dallas Mavericks owner Mark Cuban knows the answer. Earlier this month, I read the following tweet by Mark. It doesn't matter if the glass is half empty or half full. All that matters is that you are the one pouring the water. While there really isn't just one answer to the overall question, I believe Mark's post means that each of us has the ability to be the person in charge of pouring the water in life. The decisions that we make and the ability to recognize opportunities determine our successes. You also have to have passion, perseverance, and focus. I have a great story about an Iowan who at a very young age possessed all of those qualities. Ben Millen is the founder of a successful Iowa startup called Dwalla. He created his company to address interchange fees, and by the beginning of 2012, Dwalla was processing $30 to $50 million a month in transactions. It also had more than 100,000 users. As a successful entrepreneur, Ben could be located anywhere in the world, but he chose Iowa to be the headquarters for Dwalla. Ben also has attracted visible investors like Iowan entrepreneur and actor Ashton Kutcher. He is a great example of someone who recognized an opportunity when it presented itself. But recognizing opportunities doesn't just stop with people like Ben. There are many companies that are embracing a new technology revolution, including ISU startup Harris Vaccines and Ankeny-based manufacturer Acumone. In addition, Iowa's Science, Technology, Engineering and Math, or STEM initiative, is igniting like wildfire in communities across this state, working through grade schools, high schools, community colleges, universities, and businesses. In fact, STEM jobs have grown 3 times faster and have higher wages when compared to other careers. With that in mind, we believe STEM will play an important role in preparing young people for the jobs within a global economy and nurturing high growth opportunities for future generations. Now, a few of you might be thinking, well, these stories are great if you happen to be a business admin grad or if you're the entrepreneurial type who wants to start a new business, but hey, that is just not for me. Well, my advice to you is always be open-minded. Remember, everyone has the ability to recognize opportunities. It happens through addressing challenges, identifying solutions, and taking thoughtful risk. No matter where your path leads after today, you will have choices to make, problems to solve, and challenges to overcome. So if you always take a step back, seriously think about the unexpected opportunities, then your life path becomes significantly clearer. Following your life journey requires more than just taking advantage of unexpected opportunities. It also means having the courage necessary to move beyond the unknown. From a state perspective, despite the unknown, we remain focused on key priorities like new jobs for Iowans, increasing family incomes, reducing the cost of government, and providing a world-class education. But right now, your perspective of the unknown might be a little scary. You're getting ready to enter an entirely new phase of your life. For instance, you may be starting a new job search that's aligned with your degree, or maybe you're choosing an Iowa community or city and deciding which one of those is best for you. And I want you to know that I would love it if you could stay right here in Iowa after you graduate. This new chapter in your life may seem overwhelming, but it doesn't have to be. If you're experiencing a little fear of the future, just remember this proverb. Fear is only as deep as the mind allows. Since fear exists only in your mind, it's an emotion that can be controlled, and you are the person in control of your emotions and any fears. That is why I believe that each of you has the courage to move beyond the unknown. Each of you has the power to keep an open mind, and each of you has the ability to manage how fear impacts your life. Let fear be the catalyst for action rather than the justification for inaction. You need to know that the unknown doesn't have to be uncomfortable or feared. It can lead to one of the most exciting experiences in your lifetime. And never in my wildest dreams did I imagine, as a young child growing up in a small rural town of approximately 500 people, that one day I would be standing before you as the Lieutenant Governor of Iowa. I was just a girl from St. Charles, Iowa, yet throughout my career, I've learned relevant skills and developed relationships that I might have missed out on had I not said yes to several new opportunities. When you enter the workforce, it really is all about your relationships with others. You will experience firsthand the necessity of building and maintaining relationships. That is a skill that you've probably learned while at Iowa State, and you need to continually strengthen it throughout your career. In a global economy, there are tremendous opportunities to build relationships both online and in person. Without question, in the months and years ahead, you will face a multitude of challenges, and your choices may become blurred with the unknown. But these unknowns serve as clues to your future, and these unknowns can be life-changing and life-rewarding. I'd like to conclude this part of my speech by sharing a story about Eleanor Roosevelt and her personal courage to face fear. Before you were born, and even before I was born, Eleanor was quite a force in the White House. While other first ladies were content to maybe remain behind the scene, she was quite the opposite. She held news conferences addressing issues like human rights and children's issues and women's issues. And even after President Roosevelt passed away, Eleanor was not about to ride off into the sunset and forget about her passions in life. Absolutely not. She went on to serve as a delegate to the United Nations General Assembly, and during that time, Eleanor chaired the UN's Human Rights Commission and helped write the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. And that is something that she considered to be her greatest lifetime achievement. Yet according to historians, Eleanor was heavily criticized by some while praised by others. Eleanor faced many unknowns during her life while serving as a strong voice for Americans who were often silenced. She was not afraid to speak out, and her advice on how to overcome fear is still relevant today. Eleanor would often say, "You gain strength, courage, and confidence by every experience in which you really stop to look fear in the face. You must do the one thing which you think you cannot do." Now think about what she said. Gain strength, courage, and confidence by every experience in which you really stop to look fear in the face. Wow, it takes a lot to look fear in the face. But you know, it's a mindset, and I believe by being courageous, you can gain strength and confidence. By being courageous, you can face the unknown and understand the clues surrounding you. And by being courageous, you embark upon worldly adventures that you never could have been imagined earlier in your life. Being adventurous means embracing the new and the unknown, and I certainly found that out when Governor Branstad asked me to lead past trade missions on behalf of Iowa, including ones to China, Bangkok, and South Korea. And in February, I have the opportunity to lead a trade mission to Vietnam and the Philippines. These definitely were new experiences for me. And although trade mission results are sometimes unknown for weeks, months, or years, they are extremely important for Iowa's international trade efforts to compete in a global economy. International trade is a win-win because such trade empowers American farmers and agricultural producers to help feed the world. International trade provides innovative companies like John Deere and Company to spread state-of-the-art equipment around the globe. International trade helps increase family incomes, create jobs, and encourages competition that helps people maximize their purchasing power. You know, even though Iowa is small as a state, our contributions to the world are very large. During the past 5 years, Iowa exports have grown by more than 37%, and each year, our state distributes more than $13 billion of goods around the globe. We are number one in the nation in the production of corn, soybeans, pigs, and eggs. Iowans understand the world is counting on us to feed its growing population. But Iowa's presence on the world stage is not new. In fact, Iowa State University played an important role for our state on September 23rd in 1959. That was the day that Nikita Khrushchev visited Iowa State University. As reported in the Iowa State Daily, his visit resulted in several protests and raised questions about his overall intentions while in the United States. Yet Khrushchev was so impressed by Iowa's corn production that he decided the Soviet Union should strive to become a leading corn producer. Upon returning home, Khrushchev actually earned the Russian name, the Corn Man. The recent visit of Vice President Xi Jinping of China to Iowa has been compared to Khrushchev's historic visit and once again placed our state on the world stage. Earlier this year, you may have read in the news that Vice President Xi traveled to Des Moines, where we hosted a state dinner for him at the Capitol Rotunda. Prior to the event, Vice President attended a tea reception in Muscatine, and it was during that reception he made a lasting impression on us, and he shared the following thoughts. "It's my second visit to Muscatine, and all the memories of my being here are now coming back. Coming here is really like coming back to home. You can't even imagine what a deep impression I had from my visit 27 years ago to Muscatine, because you were the first group of Americans that I came into contact with. My impression of this country came from you. For me, you are America." Being able to establish that type of a personal relationship and lasting impression nearly 30 years ago has been integral to Iowa's ability to trade with China. The day after the state dinner was held, the state of Iowa signed an agreement with China to provide more than $3 billion in soybeans to their growing country. The soybean agreement with China is a tremendous win for Iowa, and we have a great opportunity to expand our positive relationship with China in the future. Long-term and personal relationships like the one that we share with Vice President Xi are critical for competing in a global economy and for creating new jobs for graduates like you today. This is why it is so important for you to meet new people and focus on building and maintaining relationships throughout your career. Earlier in my remarks, I said that you will face a multitude of unknowns along every step of your journey. These unknowns are the clues to your future. Again, they can be life-changing, and these unknowns can be life-rewarding. And that's why the third and most important part of my speech focuses on the topic of never backing down from your true self. If you take anything away from today, I hope it will be something from these parts of my remarks. Everyone has a personal philosophy derived from their core values and beliefs. The short version of my personal philosophy is never let others define who you are or what you can be. In order to be happy in life, you must be comfortable with your true self. You should proceed on your life journey with an attitude of continuous learning. You should be passionate about your life's work and look at every opportunity to make a difference. You are the generation possessing a depth of knowledge and an intellect that is superior to all others and influenced by the wisdom of generations before you. So my parting words of wisdom for you today are simple. Tomorrow begins today as you leave this university for a lifetime adventure. Tomorrow begins today as you leave behind any doubts or fears about your future. Tomorrow begins today as you leave to shape your story and your legacy. I know these things because you are the tomorrow that begins today. You are the leaders who we will depend upon and the visionaries who will solve the issues for generations to come. You are the individuals who will move with conviction when others waver and boldly confront the challenges to defy the cynics. You are the amazing professionals who are steady in your pursuit of happiness, and you are authentic in your endeavors. Most importantly, you are the class of 2012, a community forever linked and forever Iowa, and cyclones who will move forward with courage, imagination, and integrity. You are the tomorrow that begins today. Thank you.
I want to thank the Lieutenant Governor for those wise and inspirational words. It's an honor to have you with us today. We thank you for your many contributions to Iowa and society. We'll now hear from our commencement vocalist, Simon Estes, and then from our student brass ensemble under the direction of Michael Galimo.
President Stephen Leath will now recognize students graduating with distinction and then confer degrees to the graduates.
I now call upon Dr. Jonathan Wickert, Senior Vice President and Provost, for the recognizing of students graduating with distinction and honors.
I would like to recognize at this time the graduate students who are receiving Teaching Excellence Awards and Research Excellence Awards. Students receiving these awards are being recognized for outstanding teaching and for research accomplishments in a graduate program, and they are wearing cardinal and gold honor cords. Will those students please rise? The faculty and I offer you our sincere congratulations. Please be seated. Now, I would like to recognize the undergraduate students who are graduating with distinction. Grade point averages at Iowa State University are based on a 4.0 scale. In addition to the notation on the commencement program, this recognition appears on the official transcript and diploma. Those students graduating summa cum laude with highest distinction have earned a grade point average of 3.90 or higher, and they are wearing cardinal and gold honor cords. Will those students of highest distinction please rise? Please be seated. Students graduating magna cum laude with great distinction have a grade point average of 3.70 to 3.89, and they are wearing gold honor cords. Will the students of great distinction please rise? Thank you. Students graduating cum laude with distinction have a grade point average of 3.50 to 3.69, and they are wearing cardinal honor cords. Will the students with distinction please rise? Congratulations to all of you on behalf of the faculty of the university. Next, I would like to recognize the undergraduates who are graduating from our University Honors Program. These students have maintained a cumulative grade point average of at least 3.35, have shown initiative in developing their own individualized programs of study, and ingenuity in designing and completing an independent honors research project. They are wearing medallions. Will the honors students please rise? Congratulations.
Dr. Wickert, I now call upon you for the conferring of degrees.
We shall now proceed with the conferring of the graduate degrees. Some degrees will be conferred in absentia. The Dean of the Graduate College will ask the candidates to stand and will present them to the President. After the President formally awards the degrees, the graduates will then be seated. A faculty marshal will dismiss students to come to the stage to be recognized. We'll begin with the conferring of the Doctor of Philosophy degrees, the highest degree that Iowa State University confers. I would, though, like to say a few words about the history of the academic attire and the special nature of the hooding ceremony that will take place. Academic gowns have been part of the university experience since the 12th century, and the advent of the first European universities. Because these early schools were connected to great cathedrals, like those at Bologna and Chartres, the black gown of the schoolmasters, or scholastics, emulated the somber dignity of the clergy and signified a life devoted to learning. In addition, the ample materials of the gown served to keep the scholars warm in the drafty environment of the medieval university. Hoods were also functional, like the hood on a monk's habit, while colors were reserved for masters or teachers, rather than bachelors or students. Initially, the colors indicated one's discipline, such as the green of nature for a degree in medicine. Mortar boards with black and gold tassels and school colors came much later, but the clerical formality of the academic gown continues to represent the dedication and the nobility of the scholar's vocation. During the hooding ceremony today, the degree recipients will be escorted and hooded by their major professors, who have worked with them throughout their study for the doctoral degree. The hoods will connect the graduate with a family of scholars throughout history and from all parts of the world and with Iowa State University. The Dean of the Graduate College, Dr. David Holger, will present candidates for the degree Doctor of Philosophy from the Graduate College.
The candidates for the degree Doctor of Philosophy will please rise. The Doctor of Philosophy is the university's highest academic degree, awarded only to those who have successfully completed an intensive and demanding course of study, whose primary focus is on learning to conduct original research. The final stage of the program is the preparation and defense of a thesis that describes the outcome of a major research project. To prepare for that project, the student must have gained expertise and skills in a particular discipline and must have thoroughly explored its existing knowledge base. Those who receive doctorates today have therefore demonstrated that they are truly experts in their fields, whose research has already contributed significantly to human knowledge. The hood they assume symbolizes their admission to the exclusive ranks of those who have earned the respect associated with the title Doctor of Philosophy. President Leath, these candidates have completed all required courses, have demonstrated their ability in research, and have passed all examinations. They are recommended by the graduate faculty and the faculty senate and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for the degree Doctor of Philosophy.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of respective programs in the graduate college, by the authority delegated to me by the State of Iowa, I confer upon you the degree Doctor of Philosophy, with its accompanying rights, privileges, and obligations. The diploma now to be placed in your hands and the hood with which you will be invested shall forever be the testimony of your high academic rank.
PhD candidates, please be seated. Faculty marshals will dismiss you by row to approach the stage. Saud Shihab Al-Sadi, major in mathematics, presented by Dr. Weber. Sacha Andalam, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Ilya. Naga Durga Prasad Averneni, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Somani. Abdel Hamid Azaz, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Shogren Knack. Maria Diane Bentrot, major in Human Development and Family Studies, presented by Dr. Margaret. Laura Lynn Bestler, major in Education, presented by Dr. Evans. Axton Elliott Betts, major in Human Development and Family Studies, presented by Dr. Goodmanson. Samuel Buxton, major in Toxicology, presented by Dr. Martin. Stephen Manchester Kerrigan, major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Koray Çelik, major in Computer Engineering, presented by Dr. Somani. Michael Cheng, major in Hospitality Management, presented by Dr. Rajagopal. Eric John Christian, major in Crop Production and Physiology, presented by Dr. Goji. Nichelle Lee Klein, major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers. Sandra Elaine Cooper, major in Education, presented by Dr. Evers and Dr. Starobin. Mary Darrow, major in Education, presented by Dr. Starobin. Anton Dubrovsky, major in Organic Chemistry, presented by Dr. Jeffrey Zell. Angel Nita Dunlap, major in Family and Consumer Sciences Education, presented by Dr. Caples. Adam Joseph Faith, co-major in Computer Engineering and Human-Computer Interaction, presented by Dr. Harding. Jesse Robert Fisher, major in Fisheries Biology, presented by Dr. Quist. Natalia Frischman, major in Sociology, presented by Dr. Jones Johnson. Patricio Galdamez, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Kai. Anita Marie Gordon, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Kyle Grubbs, major in meat science, presented by Dr. Lonergan. William Landon Headley, major in forestry, presented by Dr. Hall. Lisa Hetzel, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Tianming Ji, co-major in statistics and bioinformatics and computational biology, presented by Dr. Liu. Shan Jin, major in industrial engineering, presented by Dr. Ryan. Charles Kenobi, major in genetics, presented by Dr. McIntosh. Christopher Daniel Carstens, major in meteorology, presented by Dr. Gallus. Esan Kayal, major in ecology and evolutionary biology, presented by Dr. Lavrov. Mingyu Kim, major in condensed matter physics, presented by Dr. Goldman. Carrie Angela Kramer, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Bonnet. Praveen Kumar, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Meyer. Marcia Ray Lagerman, major in industrial and agricultural technology, presented by Dr. Mickelson. Marcia Ray Lagerman, major in industrial and agricultural technology, presented by Dr. Mickelson. Jennifer R. Kurter-Leptin, major in human development and family studies, presented by Dr. Brooke. Randall Lynn Levings, major in veterinary microbiology, presented by Dr. Roth. Jinrong Li, major in applied linguistics and technology, presented by Dr. Hegelhammer. Young Li, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Bowler. Chen Li, major in applied mathematics, presented by Dr. Hu. Yi Liang, major in food science and technology, presented by Dr. McDonald. Xiwan Liu, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Guan. Carlos Lopez, major in education, presented by Dr. Ebers. Yao Lu Swanson, major in apparel, merchandising, and design, presented by Dr. Neem. Yi Lu, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Bowler. Chang Ma, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Tan. Venkatesh Mani, major in toxicology, presented by Dr. Gabler. Kuntal Mana, major in inorganic chemistry, presented by Dr. Sato. Natalia Alexdrovna Markina, major in organic chemistry, presented by Dr. Greenbow. Kendra Ann Mead, major in plant breeding, presented by Dr. Beavis. Megan Louise Mikolai, major in analytical chemistry, presented by Dr. Hoke. Panchi Mang, major in industrial engineering, presented by Dr. Peters. David Anton Miller, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Guan. Hua Ming, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Chang. Mark Allen Mogler, major in veterinary microbiology, presented by Dr. Bartholomew. Farah Mukhtar, major in education, presented by Dr. Robinson. Ashwin Natarajan, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Kai. Micheline Ngaki, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Nicolau. David Matthew Niederjeses, co-major in rhetoric and professional communication and human-computer interaction, presented by Dr. Wilson. Jinhuan Oh, major in civil engineering, presented by Dr. Ellis. Sheila Navalia Onzere, major in sociology, presented by Dr. Mazur. Megan Orr, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Liu. Anne-Marie Caroline Overstreet, major in microbiology, presented by Dr. Wanamuller. Herbert William Pablo, major in astrophysics, presented by Dr. Kowaler. Yajdeep Fonse, major in immunobiology, presented by Dr. Wanamuller and Dr. Belair. Srikanth Puttachari, major in biomedical sciences, presented by Dr. Martin. Hong Chen, major in economics, presented by Dr. Hayes. Wenmin Chin, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. Nicolau. James Matthew Rinaldi, major in applied linguistics and technology, presented by Dr. Chappelle. Mohammed Hamad Rashwan, major in civil engineering, presented by Dr. Williams. William Daniel Robinson, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Kelkar. Nathan Michael Romine, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Beetham. Juan Francisco Rosas, major in economics, presented by Dr. Hayes. Alicia Rosberg, major in economics, presented by Dr. Miranowski. Zachary Lee Royer, major in materials science and engineering, presented by Dr. Lassar. Selena Marie Russell, major in physical chemistry, presented by Dr. Thiel. Ramzi Saifan, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Guan. Robert Glenn Schout, major in immunobiology, presented by Dr. Sacco. Christian Schmidt, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Wilson. Tanya Sue Schwartz, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Bronikowski. Ali Tosi, major in quantitative genetics, presented by Dr. Fernando. Yarching Si, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Liu. Lisandro Damian Solano Kinde, major in computer engineering, presented by Dr. Somani. Jordan Dustin Spear, major in plant breeding, presented by Dr. Fair. Krishna Kumar Sridharan, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Lavrov. Melissa Sturm Smith, major in education, presented by Dr. Evans. Rachel Maureen Tell, major in immunobiology, presented by Dr. Roth. Christopher Joseph Turek, major in mechanical engineering, presented by Dr. Sudhararajan. Christopher Paul Trample, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Guan. Alan Francis Trapp II, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Dixon. Tanaya Lynn Triplett, major in human-computer interaction, presented by Dr. Menicky. Chuang Wong, major in computer science, presented by Dr. Chung. Hang Wong, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Nettleton. Yisheng Wu, major in biochemistry, presented by Dr. McIntosh. Hui Xie, major in electrical engineering, presented by Dr. Song. Xing Su, major in plant biology, presented by Dr. Wang. Kai Ying, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Schnabel. Chad David Ewan, major in physical chemistry, presented by Dr. Thiel. Sha Chow, major in genetics, presented by Dr. Garrick. Yong Chu, major in nutritional sciences, presented by Dr. Hollis. Roger Zoe, major in statistics, presented by Dr. Wilson.
My congratulations to all our PhD graduates. Doctors, we are proud of all your educational achievements. Well done. Will the candidates for the master's degree please rise? The master's degree is awarded to those who have successfully completed an intensive course of study in a particular discipline, reflecting the diversity of ways in which advanced knowledge and skills can be obtained. The university awards a variety of master's degrees with specific names and expectations. In many fields, a master's degree represents the highest academic achievement, and degree holders are accorded full recognition as practitioners of its art. The master's degree often involves research and the preparation of a thesis or creative component that demonstrates an ability to conduct original inquiry. All of those who receive their degrees today have demonstrated a dedication to learning and to enhancing their abilities to contribute to society. Their degrees demonstrate that they have truly mastered a complex and demanding body of knowledge. President Leath, these candidates have completed the requirements prescribed by their prospective degree programs. They are recommended by the graduate faculty and the faculty senate, and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for their master's degrees.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of your respective programs in the Graduate College, by the authority delegated to me by the State of Iowa, I confer upon you the master's degree with its accompanying rights, privileges, and obligations. The diploma now to be placed in your hands shall forever be the testimony of this academic achievement.
Nara Melek Arpachi, Master of Science in Economics.
Michael Owen Reed, Master of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Ling-Wei Song Chu, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Jacqueline Sue Ludstead, Master of Science Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Bonnie S. Whalen, Master of Public Administration.
David Kareem Manu, Masters of Science in Meat Science and Food Science and Technology.
Tyler Stephen Husky, Master of Science in Computer Interaction.
Justin Charles Binock, Masters of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Dennis Eugene Culver, Master of Science in Education.
June E. Leo, Masters of Science in Food Science and Technology.
Adam Charles Paulson, Master of School of Mathematics.
Shannon Noel Box, Masters of Science, Food Science and Technology.
Isaac Joel Garlington, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
John M. Mazzello, Masters of Public Administration.
Zachary Aaron Kenninger, Master of Science in Forestry.
William C. Hendrickson, Masters of Public Administration.
Jessica Lee Anderson, Master of Science in Agricultural Education.
Jeffrey Allen Fletcher, Masters of Public Administration.
David A. Silveraj, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Ishia Shen, Masters of Science in Plant Breeding.
Patrick A. Grant, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Kelly Ann Klein, Masters of Science in Agricultural Education.
Andrew Kyle Neiman, Master of Engineering in Systems Engineering.
Andrew Stephen Frana, Masters of Science in Agricultural Engineering and Civil Engineering.
Laura Denise Ekstrand, Master of Science in Mechanical Engineering.
William Crosby Lust III, Masters of Education.
Enro Guo, Master of Science, Computer Science.
Andrew Alexander Fraudry, Masters of Science in Plant Biology.
Kayla Westergaard Taylor, Master of Science in Agricultural Education.
Emily Catherine Weber, Masters of Science in Animal Science.
Sarah Jane Gomet, Master of Science in Agricultural Education.
Melanie Tompkins Dormini, Masters of Science in Educational or Agricultural Education.
Sarah Christine Rye, Master of Education.
Nathan Thomas Brayman, Masters of Science in Industrial and Agricultural Technology.
Jesse Lance Struck, Master of Science in Economics.
Brian David Breckenholtz, Masters of Engineering and Mechanical Engineering.
Wei-Shing Sun, Master of Science in Materials Science and Engineering.
Brian Joseph Kilby, Masters of Engineering in Mechanical Engineering and Systems Engineering.
Amanda Marie Carlson, Master of Science in Veterinary Preventive Medicine.
Carla Jean Bromwell, Masters of Public Administration.
Caitlin Lorraine Ramsey, Master of Arts in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
Christopher Cody Helzig, Masters of Science in Crop Production and Physiology.
Sarah Ellen Merrifield, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Victoria Elsie Scott, Masters of Science in Soil Science.
Vanessa Lynn Dweet, Master of Education.
Yingfeng Shen, Masters of Science in Chemical Engineering.
Michelle Marie White, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Stacy Lee Noe, Masters of Science in Agricultural Education.
Lindsay Marie Peterson, Master of Family and Consumer Sciences.
Terry J. Hornbuckle, Masters of Family and Consumer Sciences.
John David Gard, Master of Science in Agricultural Engineering.
Tanduith Mendoza, Masters of Engineering in Computer Engineering.
Stephanie Joy Kratzer, Master of Science in Nutritional Sciences.
Brittany Nicole Schoen, Masters of Science in Industrial and Agricultural Technology and Biorenewable Resources and Technology.
Jackie R. Hayes, Master of Science in Interdisciplinary Graduate Studies.
David Andrew Prater, Masters of Science in Human-Computer Interaction.
Sarah Lynn Nichols, Master of Science in Education.
Seth Allen Vandertuig, Masters of Education in Education.
Jennifer Ann Behrens, Master of Education.
Sam Robert Van Gilleren, Masters of Science in Education.
Brenda S. Kelly, Master of Education.
Da Lee, Masters of Science, Computer Engineering and Information Assurance.
Catherine Marie Chamberlain, Master of Education.
Skylar Thomas Knickerbocker, Masters of Science in Civil Engineering.
James Lewis Craig, Master of Education.
Lucinda Marie Boyd, Masters of Education.
Sarah Jean Cook, Master of Education.
Taryn May Monin, Masters of Education.
Lisa Lynn Downing, Master of Education.
Jennifer Ray Roberts, Masters of Community and Regional Planning.
Colleen Marie Campbell, Master of Science in Kinesiology.
John Cotton Dean, Masters of Community and Regional Planning and a Masters of Science in Community and Regional Planning.
Elizabeth Louise Moss, Master of Science in Geology.
Wayne Allen Chittick, Masters of Science in Veterinary Preventative Medicine.
Gianna Marie Schierholz, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Benjamin Michael Lortz, Masters of Accounting, degree in Accounting major.
Angel Daniel Morandiera Alonso, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Aaron L. Follett, Masters of Science in Journalism and Mass Communication.
Graydon F. Marzen, Master of Science in Seed Technology and Business.
Robert Thomas Sheldon, Masters of Science in Electrical Engineering.
James L. Schweigert, Master of Science in Seed Technology and Business.
Shadney Saxena, Masters of Business Administration.
Kevin Charles O'Neill, Master of Science in Immunobiology.
Oliva Carr, Masters of Science in Computer Science and Human-Computer Interaction.
Theodore David Bechtum, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Archik Saref, Masters of Science in Computer Science.
Yereg Maulana, Master of Arts in Political Science.
Monundin Abrar Asayed, Masters of Science in Computer Engineering.
Dipkanta Chattopadhyay, Master of Science in Bioinformatics and Computational Biology.
David Christopher Mitchell, Masters of Science in Soil Science.
Christopher R. Koza, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Benjamin Clayton Barhart, Masters of Public Administration.
Daniel Dean Dvorak, Master of Science in Aerospace Engineering.
Oscar Julian Eshavara Amana, Masters of Engineering in Civil Engineering.
Brenda Renee Morningstar, Master of Science in Veterinary Microbiology.
Tian Shu, Masters of Science, Journalism and Mass Communication.
Paul Thomas Kuspatarczyk, Master of Science in Agricultural Education.
Dayu An Hodak, Masters of Science in Hospitality Management.
Fong Yu Guo, Master of Science in Civil Engineering.
Zhuzhang Khan, Masters of Science in Food Science and Technology and Biorenewable Resources and Technology.
Chi Chan, Master of Science in Veterinary Microbiology.
Ryan David Hechtemann, Masters of Engineering and Aerospace Engineering. Xing Zhang, Masters of Science in Chemical Engineering.
Congratulations to all those receiving their master's degrees today. We take great pride in your accomplishments.
We shall now proceed with the conferring of undergraduate degrees and the awarding of diplomas. Will all of the candidates for the bachelor's degree please rise? President Leath, these candidates have satisfactorily completed their prescribed curricula in their respective colleges. They have been recommended by the college faculty and the faculty senate and are approved by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, for the bachelor degree from Iowa State University.
In recognition of the satisfactory completion of your studies in the respective colleges and by the authority granted to me by the Board of Regents, State of Iowa, I confer upon you your bachelor's degree. As is tradition, I ask that all bachelor's degree recipients now move their tassels from the right side to the left side of their cap. Congratulations.
Candidates from each college will walk up the side stairs, up to the platform, and across the stage to be recognized. We will begin with the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Dean Wendy Winterstein will present the college's student marshal to President Leath.
President Leath, Provost Wickard, it is my privilege to present the student marshal from the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, Brittany Jurgemeyer, who is graduating summa cum laude with a bachelor's degree in Public Service Administration in Agriculture with minors in Agricultural Education, Journalism, and Mass Communications. She is escorted by Dr. Richard Schultz, University Professor in Natural Resource Ecology and Management. During her collegiate career, Brittany volunteered in rural Africa and the Caribbean and was selected as a member of Iowa State's National Collegiate Agricultural Ambassador Team for 2 years. Brittany will continue her studies at Drake University with plans to earn a master's degree. Please join me in congratulating Brittany Jurgemeyer.
Karen K. Robinson.
Isaac Thomas Mertz.
Laura Ray Helmick.
Joshua Robert Tapman.
Brianna Faye McNeil.
Megan Ruth Beershank.
Catherine Marie Miller.
Katie Sue Keller.
Jacqueline Lene Amiss.
Kaylin Lynn Ryder.
Mary Edith Kolthoff.
Brian Patrick Mike.
Laura Catherine Lichty.
Demian Hoosh.
Allison Marie Riley.
Jeffrey Lee Klump.
Matthew Lee Brissy.
Sean Robert Moore.
Sarah Beth Dempsey.
Brett Alien McArthur.
Christopher James Bird.
John Tyler Reimertz.
Jerry Michael Cervantes.
Austin James Brandhorf.
Juliana Nicole Cruz.
Jordan Joseph Voss.
Cassandra Gwen Hintz.
Brent Michael Blackford.
Rosalind Marie Punt.
Michael Glenn Koenig.
Samantha Ann Stegman.
Caitlin Louise Knutson.
John Charles Dosey.
Megan O'Toole Masterson.
Victoria R. Farwell.
Nicole Faye Noodleman.
Brandy Lynn Hofstadter.
Caitlin R. Herman.
Tyler Allen Hofstadter.
Paige Alexandra Moore.
Jan Chun.
David Aaron Hybenson.
David Allen Rolfs.
Sean Michael Bradley.
Madison Lee Van Gorp.
Jordan Daniel Lidman.
James M. Crane.
Jason Edward Reese.
Mark Ayuan Makur.
Glenn Daniel Robinson.
Stuart Allen Hall.
Laura Yannette Belio.
Evan A. Newman.
Joel Evan Tierman.
Amanda Rose Corrigan.
Mark Jeffrey Charlotte.
Adam Kyle Driesen.
Joshua James Appletoft.
Leah Josephine Waddle.
Robert Kenneth Manat.
Luke Hua Wong Shin.
Blake Warner McManus.
John Yuk Shin.
Jonah Wagner Ewers.
Isaac Kwasi Owusu. Joel Edward Cox. Jennifer Lee Files. Lizelle Patricia Bragg. Anna Elizabeth Earhart. Clinton Eugene Martin. Kelsey Ann Sandin. Joe Michael Studer. Caitlin Elizabeth Sandin. Shulting Dong. Achi Chan. Shongyang Chan. Amanda K. Scavo. Chung Long Liu.
I want to congratulate the graduates from the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. The faculty members in our college take great pride in your achievements and join me in wishing you the very best upon graduation. Please stay in touch.
And now, graduates from the College of Business. Interim Dean Michael Crum will present the college's student marshal to President Leith.
President Leith, Provost Wickert, it is my privilege to present to you
the student marshal from the College of Business, Amanda Mayberry. Amanda is escorted by her favorite instructor, Diane Whittle, Senior Lecturer of Accounting. Amanda is graduating magna cum laude today with a Bachelor's of Science in Accounting. She has recently accepted a position with PricewaterhouseCoopers as a Risk Assurance Associate. Throughout her time at Iowa State, Amanda has balanced her studies with 4 years as a student athlete on ISU's soccer team, has completed 3 internships, and has been involved in an array of student and community activities, including volunteering at Food at First and Ames Community Schools. She was an academic, all Big 12, first team, and ISU scholar athlete. Amanda attributes her academic success to the support of her family and friends and the high expectations to which professors held her accountable for throughout her adventure at Iowa State. Please join me in congratulating Amanda.
Taylor James Ross. Robert C. Feeney.
Fei-Yung Hu.
Ivan V. Martirosov.
Yan-Chin Gu.
Ruben V. Martirosov.
Yan-Lin Li.
Timothy Allen Kuntz.
Bin Chu.
Ryan James Pithun.
Su Chang.
Jacob Patrick Gosler.
Joyoung Chang.
Forrest Vaughn Ward.
Yiru Fang.
Amanda Renee Bush.
Shangyi Li.
Alicia Jean Watrous.
Jared Joseph Kosterman.
Nicholas Lee Smith.
Upabale Das Sarma.
Robert Andrew Padaruka.
Ana Cristina Victores Roboredo.
Zachary James Ramsey.
Renan Wong.
Eric J. Sarwine.
Karen Yvette Ferreira.
Jake L. Ferrazzi.
Jamie Ann Kolb.
Lori Ann Hancock.
Hong Pung.
Benjamin Yeboah.
Fulatsame Prasit.
Leanne Marie Harold.
Xinyang Chong.
Khan Huan.
Yanan Shu.
Lingzhu Xu.
Bo Yang.
Jian Chen.
Xitian Ding.
Jixuan Xian.
Christian Catherine Klein.
Jun Fu.
Yifu Chao.
Weiji Tang.
Yanjing Shu.
Caitlin Darlene Weiss.
Qi Guo.
Laura Elizabeth Potts.
Yang Li.
Hansen Xing.
Fan Yang.
Brian Randy Fuller.
Yang Yang.
Joseph Daniel Bovia.
Lejing Cha.
Garrett S. Garner. Jonathan Douglas Van Dyke. Mijing Kok.
Congratulations to the graduates from the College of Business. I know that the faculty in our college join me in wishing you the very best upon graduation, and we encourage you to keep in touch with Iowa State University. Congratulations.
And now the College of Design. Dean Luis Rico Gutierrez will present the college's student marshal to President Leith.
President Leith, Provost Wickert, it is my honor and privilege to present to you the student marshal for the College of Design, Dublin Stupczynski, escorted today by Professor Fred Madden. Dublin is graduating cum laude with a Bachelor of Fine Arts in Interior Design and a minor in Performing Arts. She is from Lindenhurst, Illinois, and is the daughter of David and Linda Stupczynski. Dublin has been on the Dean's list for 4 years and is a member of the Cardinal Key Honor Society. She studied abroad with the College of Design Rome program and completed summer internships with Britt Carter and Company in Lake Forest, Illinois, and celebrity designer Courtney Cashett in New York. Dublin has been actively involved in intramurals and has served as a dance marathon committee member, student admissions representative, and scenic designer for several ISU theater productions. She also wrote movie reviews for the Iowa State Daily and volunteered with organizations like Access in Ames. Dublin chose Associate Professor Fred Malvin to be her escort today because he challenged her to think more creatively and provided valuable feedback and encouragement to help her refine her projects. But most of all, he reminded her of the fun there is in design. After graduation, Dublin hopes to become a film set designer. Congratulations, Dublin.
Angeline Reza Chandra.
Philip M. Cassia.
Diana Alim.
Greg Robert Rahm.
Xiaoshu Du.
Natalie Crystal Waddle.
Monica Lynn Amon.
John E. Bricks.
Hannah Marie Gilman.
Jihi Shong.
Chad Ryan Powell.
Yang Zha On.
Arti Vongpagdi.
Graduates, on behalf of the College of Design faculty, staff, and students, I offer sincere congratulations and best wishes for all the future may hold for you.
And now the College of Engineering. Interim Dean Mafit Akink will present the college's student marshal to President Lee.
President Leith, it is my privilege to present to you the student marshal from the College of Engineering, Paul or Pasha Brezhnev, escorted by Dr. Sei Ki Ong, Professor of Environmental Engineering. Pasha is graduating with a double major in civil engineering and French and a minor in math. He received a high scholarship award in the College of Engineering and in the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences for maintaining a grade point average in the top 2%. He's a Cardinal Key Honor Society member, recognizing his leadership, service, and academics. Pasha studied and interned in Switzerland, worked as a research assistant in the ISU Structural Engineering Laboratory, and completed an internship in Des Moines. He volunteered for Engineers for a Sustainable World to bring rainwater harvesting to
to a village in India and also volunteered at Food at First in Ames to help gather food and prepare meals. After graduation, Pasha will join Boeing's commercial aircraft group in Seattle as a structural design engineer. We wish him the very best in his future endeavors.
Kevin Thomas Deach.
John Raymond Schobilden.
Brandon Michael Schulter.
Robert Paul Dalusay.
Neil Allen Weiss.
Philip James Jackman.
Paul Joseph Nalen.
Preston Alec Gable.
Blair Michael Billings.
Alex Wayne Steffens.
Kurt Daniel Cole.
John Gordon Detler.
Nathaniel Paul Isenbeis.
Wai Jean Tron.
Brad Kenneth Kirkpatrick.
Nock Nu Pon.
Mark Robert Hansen II.
Kimberly Eve Uwe.
Benjamin John Allen.
Adam Poller Rodegi.
Michael John Forrester.
Kyle Allen Severs.
Colin D. Hicks.
Bryce Allen Oji.
Michael Thomas Chickey.
David James Lucan.
Gregory Morgan Hazen.
Michael Ray Baer.
Emily Ann Kaufman.
Andrew Kenneth Lyons.
Cody Thompson.
Jake Ryan Trillinger.
Nicholas Everett Williams.
Corey Lee Vasek.
Molly Ann Sturgis.
Scott Charles Smith.
Alyssa Marie Bertelson.
Jujin Huao.
Claudia Veronica Martinez.
Patrick Michael Johnson.
Heather Jane Schulte.
Timothy Joseph Clayton.
Austin David Holman.
Jordan R. Platty.
Sean Michael Hubiter.
Nathan William Rejus.
Jeremy Stephen Hansen.
Douglas Harold Johnson.
Anthony Gene Simon.
Brian Patrick Hubbard.
Benjamin Katonia Kwaza.
Mark Joseph Friel.
Philip Maliana Carre.
Michael Donald Sheston.
Habad Al Kahalil.
Tyler Scott Coombe.
Stephen A. Weinert.
Cole John Van Rysweek.
Mark Joseph Trost.
Alex Mark Grudengeorge.
Matthew Allen Bimester.
Nicholas John Mon.
Benjamin R. Rome.
Joshua Timothy Singsack.
Justin K. Memert.
Lee Charles Yoakum.
Alex Michael Fullenkamp.
Andrew Scott Thielen.
Jeremy Dean Vitito.
Kara Elizabeth Ecom.
Timothy Charles Mildenberger.
Marie Catherine, who's next?
Curtis E. Anderson.
Timothy Joseph Gaffney.
Michael Aaron Yeager.
Patrick James Rumsza.
Joseph Lee Houston.
Michelle Lee Shoemaker.
Jan Schroeder.
Veronica Bernice Bryant.
Alex V. Fagan.
Michael Philip Brummer.
Alex Thomas Kelly.
Justin Frederick Strom.
Kyle Lester Lynch. Andrew Jacob Dennis.
Noah David Kadra.
Christopher Michael Diviak.
Carl Lloyd Youngdahl.
Mark Henry Zinda.
Kent Michael Recker.
Matthew James Sleater.
Darren Arthur Goza.
Jacob Scott Williams.
Grant Matthew Kirkman.
Jared Lee Kuliha.
Luke Arthur Swanson.
Ryan D. Peets.
Benjamin D. Brabant.
Jesse William Dowding.
Matthew F. Motti.
Mason Jerome Beaker.
Ebenezer Godwin Shajia.
Jordan Lee Harrison.
Jordan Lee Elif.
Lisa Jamie Nelson.
Robert Michael DeGeorge.
Timothy Mark Sprick.
Gregory Joseph Tomka.
Daniel Bofer Donatucci.
Yui Yi Lo.
David Thomas Zimmerman.
Aaron Christopher Wassell.
Sean Yong Mang.
Sean Patrick Blue.
Francis Favis Ferrer.
Tyler Blaine Johnson.
Richard Allen Page Jr.
Kenneth Vaughn Johnson.
Allison Marie White.
Brody James Upa.
Nicholas Jean Ludwig.
Brandon Lee Malice.
Jennifer Michelle Grubb.
Ryan Glenn McLeish.
Justin Lee Batchelor.
Jacob Martin Dystra.
Mark Victor Monnet.
Shane T. Gherkin.
Meredith Renee Gibson. Stephen Edward Schutte.
Sean Ray McKenzie.
Jeremy Gerald Sprecher.
Joel Benjamin Methy.
Zachary Allen Cole.
Brett Joseph Hauser.
Justin Michael Breckenridge.
Clark Joseph Enos.
Chi Chung Chu.
Brett Christopher Ebert.
Ruiz J. Chung.
Jared Thomas Weatherall.
Andrew Philip Schmitz.
Chelsea Louise O'Connor.
John Walter Corkery.
Tricia Alice Salinas.
Christine Le Yin Yi.
Craig Matthew Sink.
Leif M. Abbas.
Robert Owen Gowdy.
Jacob Sprecher.
Eric Daniel Schultner.
Dean Raymond Sayer.
Kristen Elizabeth Dahm.
Shimin Lee.
Nicholas David Everett.
Fei Wu.
Kevin Robert Stoll.
Xu Sheng Su.
Thomas Graham Hindley.
Sun Chong.
Timothy Alvin Bork.
Clarence Albert Boright.
Aaron Ubi Sun.
Mark Shahata.
Daniel Patrick O'Connor.
Michael James Smith.
Matt Troms.
Pong Mo.
Joshua P. Miller.
Yungang Chow.
Jijan Ren.
Liu Hui Guo.
Ryan Howard Smith.
Anthony Wayne Swope.
Xiao Zhang.
Ryan Patrick Pekanowski.
Li Yan. Daniel Robert Richards.
Vu An Huynh.
Stephen Lawrence Amberg.
Bolun Li.
Timothy John Pearson.
Amarani Jacqueline Tapia.
Trevor James Dobbs.
Joseph M. Klass.
Caitlin Elizabeth Krabby.
Kellyanne Markham.
Paul Daniel Speed.
Matthew White Thompson.
Kevin Michael Poole.
Sean Brandon Humes.
Jason William Bergman.
Xiaohao Long.
Andrew George Burick.
Kyle Russell Bradwell.
Adam Douglas Walker.
Guo Dong Chua.
Tyler Michael Zaz.
Gregory Yu.
John Paul Brendel.
Cheryl May Shang Ko.
Ethan James Bringiger.
Eric Mark Forbes.
Patrick Michael D. Flattery.
Sean Mark Vandesoil.
Catherine Marie Harms.
Andrea Taylor Forbes.
Heidi Elizabeth Turner.
Kelly Peterson Voss.
Justin Shane Huntington.
Wesley Scott White.
Daniel Robert Baldwin.
Alan Wayne Bentley.
Eric Paul Schmidt.
Ray Alexander Larson.
Jordan Anthony Jobes.
Sydney Lee Brady.
James Adrian Rich.
Diego A. Camargo Maldonado.
Katerin Marie Mitchell.
Dao Yan Lim.
Colton Marshall Kennedy.
Ha Tien Bai.
Elliot Knapp Hunt.
Yishan Lee.
Riley Benjamin Thiesfield.
Timothy Ryan Kalpin.
William Frederick Laurie.
Ayub Alderrahim Ali.
Renee Hamilton.
Bing Bai.
Mario Camario Peralta.
Shui Tong Mao.
Jared Michael Peterson. Austin Lee Bagg. Christopher Joseph Edwards. Eric William Johnson. Jordan Brent Handel. Kathleen Grace Maurer. Brian T. Alley. Jonathan Davis Driggs. Ishun Chow. Kinpen Ruan. Mohammed Tahrir Faramanan. Fahit M. A. R. Asiri. Hemet Banat. Monjun Ma.
I want to congratulate the graduates from the College of Engineering. The faculty members in our college join me in wishing you a successful and happy future. We are proud of your accomplishments. Please, and I know you will stay in touch with us, get back to us, visit with us. Congratulations again.
Next, the College of Human Sciences. Dean Pamela White will present the college's student marshal to President Leath.
President Leath, Provost Wickert, the first student to receive a diploma from the College of Human Sciences is our student marshal, Holly Buck, and she is escorted today by Cheryl Lindholm, academic advisor in the School of Education. Holly, who hails from Denison, Iowa, is a warm, wonderful, astute, and well-prepared future teacher. Holly is graduating magna cum laude with two bachelor's degrees, one in elementary education and one in music. She has earned additional teaching endorsements in reading, English, and language arts. Holly has demonstrated outstanding leadership as an active member of the College of Human Sciences Dean's Advisory Board, the School of Education Director Search Committee, the Freshman Council Philanthropy Committee, the Eaton Hall House Cabinet, and several instrumental ensembles. Holly has mentored her peers in both the Preparing Tomorrow's Teachers and the Esprit de Corps learning communities. She has also mentored middle school and high school students in the Science Bound program. Fortunate are the children who will soon be able to call Holly teacher. Join me in congratulating Holly.
Jessica Lynn Francis.
Dylan Thomas Eagle.
Justin Lee Hoff.
Zachary Warren Moses.
Stephanie Jean Bender.
Sarah Mitchell Mastanoana.
Sarah Christine Biller.
Jeffrey Robert Ploster.
Cassandra Celeste Cleveland.
Lauren Francis Hale.
Brock J. Johnson.
Ryan James Lynch.
Sean Lee Schwabe.
Jared Lee Phillips.
Alexandra Nicole Rassier.
Elena Lorraine Hurst.
Jesse Joseph John Negret.
J.C. Ray Murphy.
Laura Lovan.
Susan Marcos.
Michelle Elizabeth Rasmussen.
Ashley Marie Culver Moore.
Marie Teresa Fournier.
Jordan Janelle Myers.
Kayla A. Marsh.
Renee Michelle Ratliff.
Mallory Evelyn Tinglove.
Marcy Joelle Brinkman.
Michael David Kilworth.
Samantha Renee Butler.
Meredith Ann Doran.
Megan Mitchell Hankins.
Rebecca Janet Leonard.
Xu An Yu.
Benjamin James Hurley.
Yining Zhang.
Sarah Louise Albers.
Jonathan Andrew Underberg.
Lauren Nicole Kaspersky.
Kyle Leo Inwerson.
Melissa K. Lau.
Gina Rebecca Topol.
Yu Ting Tang.
Brittany Nicole Fairholm.
Cho Ping Tan.
Jessime Michela Adams.
Jali Chang.
Russell Leonard Wright.
Anna Rose Brubaker.
Ann Ruth Hornick.
Tara Macon Parrott.
Ashley Ann Olberding.
Katie Teresa Freaking.
Matthew Kevin Van Dyke.
Rachel Lynn Stokely.
Travis Jordan Wetzel.
Thomas Michael Miller.
Lauren Marie Engelbrand.
Allison Lurie Hayes.
Laura Rose Beaver.
Jennifer Ann Garter.
Kayla Ann Hammond.
Corrine Latoya Seward.
Brittany Lee Kremel.
Muhammad Noor Lohan Bean.
Katie Lynn Betton.
Myra Garcia.
Amanda Marie Lawrence.
David Michael Ahrens.
Ann Teresa Senek.
Leah Ryan.
Alexa Ray Ashcraft.
Connor Maria Healy. Samuel David Baker. Brianne Denise Dieterman. Tricia Ann Betcher.
I wish to congratulate all the graduates from the College of Human Sciences. We know we can expect great things from all of you as you go forth to expand human potential.
And now the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Dean Beate Schmidtman will present the college's student marshal to President Leath.
President Leath, Provost Wickard, the first student to receive a diploma from the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences is our student marshal, Misha Olson, a senior graduating summa cum laude with degrees in biology and Spanish. She is escorted by Dr. Jonathan Wendell, distinguished professor and chair of the Department of Ecology, Evolution, and Organismal Biology. Misha has conducted undergraduate research in Dr. Wendell's laboratory for 3 years. She has performed DNA sequencing and analysis on plants. She is also a dedicated member of the Skunk River Navy. That's a volunteer student organization which removes large amounts of trash from the Skunk River in Ames. Misha's other extracurricular activities include being a peer mentor for Introduction to Biology, and an honors ambassador, participating in dance marathon and being a member of the Biological Sciences Club and ISU Democrats. This fall, she introduced President Obama on campus in front of a crowd of thousands. After graduation, Misha plans to complete her research project in Dr. Wendell's lab, followed by graduate school in the fall.
Ismael Ndoya Koutu.
Xiaolan Fan.
Christine Alicia Griffin Johnson.
Zhao Zhu.
Shangguang Hu.
Christopher Alexander Hernandez.
Jennifer L. Zimmerman.
Christopher Nicholas Durand.
Joseph James Evans.
Samuel G. Lassisis.
Michael Jacob Sexton.
Alexandria Lynn Clouder.
Ellen Claire McGranahan.
Daniel James Reck.
Kyle Kawika Kahiwa.
Kyle Andrew Caffrey.
Lucas Samuel Crawford.
Andrew Mark Scott.
Snela Zadarovich.
Pao Moon Lau.
Anna Christine Toft.
Chloe Lim.
Chastity Carlisle Cole.
David William Colbergley.
Lashima Kayana Hampton.
Devin Kyle Mastro Deo Min Inko.
Mark Joseph Runkel.
Nathan Michael George.
Lei Song.
Aaron David Nicoletto.
Samantha Ashley Lametz.
Hayden Nicholas George.
Mary Virginia Overland.
Thomas Wayne Arnold.
Michael D. Bragg.
Kyle J. Slope.
Phap Quang Lam.
Megan James Brandt.
Elizabeth Ann Moshke.
Tyler Ray Mixon.
Cynthia Salas Salgado.
Branton Allen Eckhart.
Jamie Christine Werches.
Rachel Elizabeth Ogie.
Kelsey Marie Derkoff.
Rebecca Jean Nation.
Alicia Genevieve Kuss.
Austin Jason Suter.
Allie Madison Sean.
Benjamin Alexander Grove.
Rebecca Ann Bowen.
Haley C. Wyman.
Jocelyn Karina Brayman.
Jesse Aaron Godfrey.
Leah Janelle Hansen.
Tyler Ray Belly.
Madison Ann Reed.
Trenton A. Nun Nonstop Ulis.
Diana Catherine Wright.
Christopher John Hosenston. Kevin Jerome Schwartz. Jordan L. Hefty.
Amanda Sue Perdue.
Krista Marie Nielsen.
Courtney Tanae Leonard.
Clinton D. Wilson.
Catherine Meredith Bruns.
Andrew Mayor Angwe.
Nirmin Mohammed Fami.
Justin Marie Sharp.
Joseph T. Schwartzberger.
Kaylee Jean McCrary.
Jennifer Elizabeth Paul.
Kara Ambe Mabry.
Brittany Shan Martin.
Michael Marie Sickman.
Molly Rose Littman.
Ashley Elizabeth Spiker.
Daniel Smart.
Amanda J. Schrank.
Megan Patricia Owen.
Ryan J. Howe.
Kevin Joel Kresh.
Jessica Sue Walsh.
Nathan Andrew Von Fumetti.
Samantha Starr Jenkins.
Sarah Grace Patras.
P. Wen Lee.
Dane Morgan Whitaker.
Miranda Ray Reeder.
Chiyu Chow.
Michael Lee Cook.
Sen Tan.
Alexandra Leah Stensalv.
David Martin Shipley.
Hannah Caroline Joslin.
Andrew Christopher Apodaca.
Sean Patrick McCarthy.
Holly Sun May Kaufman.
Meredith Ann Pulsford.
Chao Chung Chang.
Michael Allen Bankson.
Morgan Elizabeth Sanders.
Mariah Rood.
Wei Li.
Jose Luis Chavez.
Zachary Allen Peterson.
Jorge Giovanni Guzman.
Aislinn Grace Diajon.
Samuel Theodore Epic.
Mark Moen.
Dustin Lane Dowell.
Jeffrey Robert Knapp.
Ryan Pei Yinchen.
Dustin Scott Payton.
John Gregory Thielen.
Alec McMillan Burns.
Phyllis Ann Shimon.
Emily Marcine Doerter.
Daniel Joe Johnston.
Rachel Marie Petsch.
Kurt Michael Hammerschmidt.
Victoria Eileen Pilja.
Emily Elise Helzik.
Brandon Isaac Kowalski.
Timothy Marker Ruder.
Kimberly J. Cobb.
Jason Nathaniel Carlson.
Joseph Lonida Lomoti.
Emily Michelle Stout.
Sydney Robert Pitt.
Kelsey Lane Larson.
Ross Jared Hackerson.
Jinjiao Wang.
Jordan Lindsay Welker.
Zhijiang Wan.
Emily Erin Martin.
Jerome Alexander Tiller.
Linda Nicole Brewer.
Ronnie Nelson.
Monica Claire Van Horn.
Stephanie Nicole Majors.
Courtney K. Guttenheis.
Long Wan.
Bettina Kantongi.
Xinping Kong.
Jordan Sue Parker.
Ongto Shen.
Cicely Yvonne Shaw.
Amy Nicole Stover.
Jessica Patrice Cameron.
Ann Michelle Swellenberg.
Masha Lanu Mishakai.
John Allen Lang.
Jia Yi Lu.
Lori Michelle Johnson.
Rim Noi.
Adria Claire Olson.
Lei Wang.
Abri Charlotte Beck.
Lee Wong.
David Paul Miller.
Justin Bryant Lewis.
Mallory Louise Hall.
Pershawn Byron Wise Mathis. Victor Octavio Sanchez. Peter Anthony Efforts. Catherine Marie Meinig. J. Pong Chuan Hong. Heather Joyce Deaton. Lee Page Destival.
Congratulate the graduates from the College of Liberal Arts and Sciences. Well done. I know the faculty members in our college join me in wishing you the very, very best upon graduation. Do come back and see us often.
On behalf of the entire university, I want to extend our sincere congratulations to all of the graduates. At this time, it's a great pleasure of mine to present to you Michelle Stotts, Vice President of the ISU Alumni Association, who will now welcome you as Iowa State University's newest alumni.
Thank you, President Leith. Greetings from your Iowa State University Alumni Association, and congratulations, graduates. Welcome to the next phase of your Iowa State adventure as Iowa State's newest alumni. As a proud ISU alumni myself, let me give you a glimpse of what awaits you. There are over 227,000 living alumni of Iowa State University who are excited to get to know you and to welcome you as fellow alumni. They live in all 99 Iowa counties, all 50 states of the U.S., and in over 140 countries. So make sure to become involved and get to know them. The Iowa State alumni love to interact with you and help out fellow alumni with anything such as career advice or information on your new communities. Networking through game watches as well as other club activities is a great way to meet other Iowa Staters. We encourage you to stay connected, be involved, and stay abreast of issues affecting ISU. You will be an alum of Iowa State for a very long time. The value of your degree is directly correlated to the reputation of the university. How you perform, the decisions you make, and the decisions we make all build the reputation and continuing value of the university, and thus your degree from Iowa State University. Be sure to keep your contact information current, including addresses, emails, and phone numbers. This will help us keep you current with things that are happening with Iowa State and other ISU alums. Another thing ISU alums do is make ISU visible in their personal and professional lives. They show their loyalty and pride by wearing Iowa State gear, displaying their diploma in their office, and making ISU items visible in wherever they live. I challenge you to see how you can make ISU more visible. And of course, I encourage you to become members of the ISU Alumni Association to enhance the connections and the communications with ISU and other alumni. The online alumni directory is a valuable resource to connect with other Iowa Staters for advice on careers and for information in new communities, as well as to connect with former classmates. When you return to campus, and we hope that's often, we hope you will visit us in the ISU Alumni Center, which is the home for all ISU alumni, students, and friends. And you can start that tradition today, as we are hosting a reception for all graduates and their families immediately following this ceremony. While there, we encourage you to participate in the tradition of having your picture taken in your cap and gown with the bronze Cy outside of the Alumni Center. Cy will also be available inside, so make sure you bring your cameras. Before we leave today, we will sing the traditional song of our alma mater, the Bells of Iowa State. This song has special meaning for all Iowa State alumni. Each time you hear it, may you reflect on your days at Iowa State and cherish your degree. May your Iowa State spirit always be true and valiant. In the years ahead, we look forward to serving you and to helping you remain active members of the Iowa State family. Once again, congratulations, and as always, go Cyclones!
We're now nearing the end of our fall commencement ceremony, and I want to offer my personal congratulations to all the graduates and to extend my thanks to all those that supported these graduates along the way. I also want to send a special thank you to Lieutenant Governor Reynolds for being our commencement speaker today, and congratulate Dr. James Barnard on receiving his honorary degree. To our graduates, congratulations. We are very proud of you, and we look forward to what you will contribute as leaders in our businesses, professions, communities, and the world. Before we close today, we also want to recognize the hard work of those who helped make this day possible. Our faculty members, your advisors, our staff, and the fathers, mothers, grandparents, sisters, brothers, partners, children, and many friends have supported these graduates all along the way. So in that end, I'd like to ask the graduates to please rise, look for your family and friends in the audience, and wave a thank you to them. I now ask those in the audience, the family and friends of these wonderful graduates, to rise. Show them your support. Thank you. Now please remain standing as we conclude our commencement ceremony, and please remain standing as the platform party recesses. Thank you all for being part of this very important and significant occasion. And now, with the singing of the Bells of Iowa State by graduating senior Aaron Hoffmeyer, I pronounce the fall 2012 commencement at a close.
Please join me in singing the Bells of Iowa State. The words can be found on the back cover of your program.
True and valiant love.